Jazz. Welcome to Jazz 101. This is an instructional video about how to play jazz. Have you ever wanted to play jazz? No? Well, you will want to now. In this instructional video, Jazz 101, you will learn how to play bebop. Jazz is amazing. So, we will now make you learn how to play jazz. We will chain you to the ground until you learn how to play it. Because that's jazz. Jazz. Meet Miles Applebaum, a guitar player that will show you how to play bebop.
First, I'm going to show you a bebop lick. It goes like this. If you can't play that, try again, but at a slower tempo.
Now, how has bebop inspired you throughout your life?
Life is bebop, and bebop is life, and that's the way I live my life.
As a bebop.
I will quote Wayne Krantz
from the Jazz Bible.
Improvisational playing, by contrast, includes any spontaneously created music.
Well said. Meet Marcus, the jazz drummer who will teach you how to play jazz.
Hello, friends. I am Marcus, the jazz drummer. I am the jazz drummer. The first thing you need to know about jazz drumming is listen to a lot of Dave Weckl. He is the jazz drummer that inspired me to play jazz. He plays double bass. He plays really tense on the ride cymbal. That's the way to play jazz. Sometimes I like to do the ride pattern on the bell. Sometimes I like to flip the sticks over on the other side. This gets a really fat, killing sound, like us jazzers say. Also, if you want to play the bass drum really hard, I would do that, especially behind a combo of a piano player and a saxophonist and a bassist that's not mic'd. That's killing.
How has bebop influenced your life?
It is my life.
What?
It is my life.
Bebop is your life.
Bebop is my life.
Meet Alex Cross. He is the piano player in a piano band, and he loves to play jazz. He will show you what it means to be a piano player in the band and how to comp successfully behind solos.
I'm sorry, I'm gonna do what? Like, what am I doing?
You know, the first thing that I like to do, because I'm a jazz key player, is I like to warm up my hands. And there's a lot of ways you can do this, but my personal favorite, the hands like it. After you get, you know, a little tired of doing that, there's always alternatives.
As an Amazonian master of the ivories, I have been given the task of comping behind soloists. Now, what you may be wondering is, how can this be done? How can this be? How can this happen? Well, allow me to show you. It all starts with the guide tones. The guide tones are basically any two notes you want. Any two notes. So I can do... pretty cool, right? Better yet. Even better. Now the whole art of comping is filling in space in between. Now that means if a soloist is playing, you want to play as much behind them as humanly possible. For example, if I am singing my part as the soloist, I would comp like so.
etc., etc.
Very good.
It is pretty good.
Comping is not the only thing you have to do, because you're required to solo. Because this is jazz. We're hip. We're cool. We're swinging. We're in the club. We're getting ass and all that. So, allow me to show you how to solo. You have to play chords with your left hand, which, much like comping, can be any variation of chords and notes that you want. Make sure you use quarter note rhythms for intricacy.
How has bebop influenced your life?
It's always been something growing inside of me. Can't contain it. And one day it'll all explode out.
Meet Aaron Podies. He is a jazz bass player, and he plays jazz with all the other bass players when they're not there because you can only have one bass player at a time. He will show you the role that the bass player needs to take on while playing jazz.
See you there. My name's Aaron Podietz, and today I'm going to be showing you how playing in thumb position is much more important than any other technique you'll learn on the bass. So, the bass is probably the least important instrument in all of jazz. That's why I picked it, because it's very easy to play, and you can just pick up and play anything, and it's very simple. And so I'll show you a few tricks to minimize the amount of effort that you put into your playing and maximize the amount of mediocrity that you generate. First, I'm going to show you why everything in regular position is too difficult to be bothered with. And then I'll show you how everything in thumb position is much easier. To maybe develop this concept a little bit more, if you have played electric bass before, you may notice that you have four notes underneath all your fingers if you spread them out each on a fret, 1, 2, 3, 4. On upright bass, the strings are much longer, so like that cheap stuff isn't gonna work anymore. You got four fingers, you can only use three of them. 1, 2, 3, those are half steps. This is like putting my fingers on frets. 1, 2, 3, that's all I can use in this position. So obviously if I'm gonna play a B major scale, you notice that I can't do that right now because the top note is playing a B flat. I just can't do it, it's not gonna work. In thumb position, everything is much, much easier because you can get the span of four notes that you obtain when playing electric bass. So you notice that if my thumb rests on the G, then I have G, A flat, A, and B flat underneath all my fingers. It's much easier than doing that shit down here. See, the voice, like, what am I even doing? It's impossible.
How has bebop influenced your life?
Bebop is probably the most profound music of all music I've ever experienced. And that's why the real book is so important. Because every bebop tune ever invented is in there. People who write new stuff, it's not going to be as good. That's why in jazz we use this thing called the real book. It's probably the most important tool for a jazz player, and it contains every song ever written
And any of the new stuff that people write is just all bullshit. You don't need to listen to that. This is where it's at.
Meet Seth. He plays the saxophone in a band that plays jazz, and he's gonna teach you how to play jazz on the saxophone. How has bebop influenced your life?
What's bebop? I don't understand. I always just play the blues. I don't understand. Isn't everybody always talking about bebop and cool? It's just a blues. Everything is all about the blues. That's all Charlie Parker ever did. He just played the blues all day long. From sunup to sundown, he sat in his room and prayed to blues. That's all I want to do, is pray to blues all day long. Did you know that's all it is? They call it jazz music. It's not. It's not. It never was. It's not even American. It's just a blues. See, this is a cup of the blues, and I pray to blues on this. This is a cup of brew. Saxo brew. You see, you understand how it works? Now I'm drinking the brews, and I'll pray the brews later. I don't really feel like it, because I'm kind of brew right now. By the way, Philip, this is a crappy cup of brews.
Why the long face, Seth?
I feel kind of brew.
Why don't you express your feelings with the blues?
The what?
Blues? The blues.
The blues?
Yeah, the,
oh,
the blues. The blues.
You want me to pray to blues?
Yeah.
Okay, pray to blues, brother. Just pray to blues. Okay, I'm going to pray to blues for you guys.
Sandu.
Shandru! Duh! Okay, right. Learn to speak correctly.
We'll be right back.